Hey, welcome to episode 123, episode 123 of Star Wars Galaxies with Yivvits and Mr. Bubble for Wednesday, December 16th, 2009.
I have to report to the council.
Oh, yes. You go, Obi-Wan, and when you come back, you will learn that since 2005, we've been your source of Star Wars Galaxies information, Tiger Woods updates, and salad bar etiquette.
Really?
Tonight's episode, your voicemails, news, excitement, and Yivvits!
And Yivvits is here.
Boy, you can't beat that. You got everything.
Here I am, Mr. Bubble.
Yes.
How are you, sir?
Oh, just dandy.
Are you just peachy?
I'm dandy.
I think I said peachy before, and you were like, what?
I'm like, raise eyebrow.
Is that kind of like a fruit, apricot-y?
I always go for a good peach. There we go. I don't get those.
Yeah. Oh, I agree.
Oh, yes, yes.
I agree, too.
Yes.
I am Yivvits, and you are Mr. Bubble, and we are Star Wars Galaxies with Yivvits and Mr. Bubble.
Right. Still.
We have not changed it
since
the last time.
Still Star Wars Galaxies.
Still, currently, up to this point,
right.
Star Wars Galaxies with Yivvits and Mr. Bubble.
Next week, it might be Minesweeper with Yivvits and Mr. Bubble. But
it might be. You don't know.
Yep.
I can't say any better than you can.
No, no.
Spider Solitaire with Yivvits and Mr. Bubble.
That sounds good.
I don't like spiders, though.
Oh, okay.
So can we skip that one?
Sure. No, yeah, no problem.
I'd appreciate it.
Microsoft Hearts on the network, on over net BIOS?
No.
A what?
No.
What?
I know what it is.
What?
It's Excel, the MMO experience with Yivvits and Mr. Rubble.
Excel 2003? Or which
one? No, it doesn't matter. It's the new MMO from Sony Online Entertainment.
Oh.
You have to pick one of the two factions. The order of the column or the Guild of Rose. I've been thinking about this.
That's pretty good, actually.
Yeah, the Order of the Columns.
I could always use that. I mean, I like spreadsheets, but I never thought about turning them into an MMO. I mean, that'd be pretty cool.
And you know what's a great ability? It's got massive DPS.
What?
The sum.
The auto.
Not the auto sum, just sum. Yeah. If you get the concatenate ability, that's really good too.
Right.
That's awesome. That's got like mad DPS, dude.
Man.
That's awesome.
Would you disable formulas so there's no cheating?
No, those
cheating?
Are the abilities.
Or just a formula?
Oh, all the formulas are abilities. Ooh. Those are your combat abilities.
Okay,
yes, yeah. And the battlefield is where the Guild of Rose meets with the Order of the Order of Columns, the column, whatever the heck I call it.
I don't know.
This is Star Wars Galaxy with Yivvits and Mr. Rubble. Come on, that was
That's
good.
Next
wasn't
week,
it?
Yeah, I know. Is that in the do we need to install the student version, the student edition?
You can, but you have to prove you're a student.
All right. Okay. Right. All right. Blah blah blah.
Really?
What is this? This is a podcast about Star Wars Galaxy. Still.
Yeah.
We kind of talked a little bit about what Star Wars is. It's a MMO game where you have rows and columns and sums and
yes, otherwise known as combat abilities.
Yes, mm-hmm. Yes. This is Star Wars Galaxies. What is Star Wars Galaxy? It's a game.
It's a game.
It's
you play.
It's a game you play. Right.
It's a monthly fee.
Yes.
You play it. I don't need, we go over that a lot.
Yeah.
Although we just started going over it again. We didn't for a while.
That's
did
fine.
We?
That's fine. It's you download it. Yeah. If you like Star Wars, it's kind of like Star Wars. You see the Star Wars people, a lot of those people in the game.
Yeah.
A lot of other people are actually other people on their computers. Kind of like World of Warcraft, right?
Yeah. That's a good analogy.
Just like that.
But different. Just like it, but different. At the core, they're all the same thing, though.
I think so. They all run on the same
server.
The
Excel spreadsheet game.
Right. Of course.
So we've been doing this show for a while now, mm-hmm. and we just continue to talk about whatever we feel like we want to talk about. Sometimes it's Star Wars Galaxy, sometimes it's not.
Right.
Sometimes it is, and sometimes it's not. It's not a summary of the news in Star Wars Galaxies. Well, I guess we do have summaries. That would probably be the best word for what we do with the news. But anyway, if you want to get more of our show, you should probably head over to www.swgpodcast.com, or you can search for us in iTunes if you like to use that method.
Oh my God, do people still use iTunes?
I don't know. Maybe they all use the Zune Marketplace.
That's what I mean. I mean, everybody I bump into is always talking Zune.
Right. Except that, especially that one guy.
Yeah.
That
right.
One, that redheaded guy.
Yeah, but right. Yeah. But I guess iTunes is still out there with the iPods, I think, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
By the way, I hate that iPad Nano commercial.
I haven't seen it. Which one's that?
Where they're all singing and like they're like holding the iPod Nano up with the screen.
Okay.
And they're all like, bah, 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 and it's one of those catchy little tunes that they always have.
Yeah.
That you're all supposed to love and everybody. And you just know that the people that make those songs are just Mac. Oh, they love Macintosh.
I love it.
And it's just really annoying. Yes. I don't know. I just wish it didn't have such cutesy ads sometimes.
Oh, go ahead.
No, you go ahead.
The Palm Pixie is pissing me off lately.
Yes.
The Palm Pixie.
Pixie. Pixie.
I mean, it's all marketing. We were just talking about it earlier. It was all marketing. Yeah. Our female coworker, she was looking at it. She's like, oh, I love the word Pixie. I love the Palm Pixie. And it's like, okay, that's fine. But it's just all marketing that makes you feel that way. I mean, I study smartphones, and the latest BlackBerry Curve has the exact same CPU as the Palm Pixie. Those are the only two devices that use that CPU.
That's
crazy. BlackBerry Curve, the updated Curve for the consumer, or the Palm Pixie, where it has all this cute music and all these happy adults, like you mentioned. They're like on the commercial, they're drinking coffee and looking at their Palm Pixies. Yeah. And then at the end, this couple is like looking at they're looking at the front. You see the back. There's a glow. They're looking at like a. Yeah, are they looking at porno pictures?
How many people sit there with a couple and they're just like, oh, we love the phone. Oh, God.
It's all marketing.
I think that was really stock footage that they had of a couple looking at their newborn baby.
Oh, yeah.
And they just inserted a Pixie instead of the baby.
Oh, a Pixie.
To get that same feeling.
All marketing, guys. Come on. Mm. It's like you got Raisin Bran. I like Raisin Bran. It's bran, it's raisins.
Yeah.
But there are multiple brands, and some have different boxes, and some have different commercials, and some have no commercials. And
it's the same thing.
Some have coupons. It's all Raisin Bran. They all call it Raisin Bran.
Yeah.
Arr.
And what I bothers me is I like Raisin Bran. What's with the Raisin Bran?
So, Palm Pixie. That bugs me. App iPod bugs you. Today we're going to listen to a lot of voicemail, right?
We are, but I was going to finish I didn't finish the plug here.
Plug, yeah. How do they get us?
By the way, we also sidetrack a lot on our show, which we love to do because it lets our minds explore every avenue that's out there. It's just we go into some weird places sometimes, but we usually get back to Star Wars somehow.
It's making me feel uneasy.
Well, I'm sorry about that too. Sometimes we do get into some strange things, but not that strange. He's kind of, what's his new deal here? He's got some new phrases.
Seasonal,
he's talking
about. I don't know.
Seasonal, he's got sad. Why do they call it sad, by the way? That's sad. Okay, I'm sorry.
I don't know.
If you want to get more of our show, go to those addresses I listed before. If you want to go to our forums, go to www.yivvitsmrbubble.com. You can send us comments at yivvitsmrbubble.com. It's an email. We would love to hear from you. Or you can send us a voicemail, and that is 888-900-9262 or YAMB. You can also send us something if you'd prefer, which we would like that as well. How would they do that?
If they want to, Yivvits, and it's just send it to Yivvits and Mr. Bubble, 168 Tyler Road, Studio 137, Red Wing, Minnesota, 55066.
There you go.
Nobody does, so I mean, what's the point? People get mad if we ask for money. If we don't ask for money, they never will.
Yeah, why did they get mad when we did that?
We're not supposed to ask for money.
Well, we never said flat out. You had maybe said it, but yeah, I mean,
and that's wrong, I guess. But
apparently it is.
It is totally wrong. I'm sorry.
I didn't say it was wrong.
I know. I don't think it's wrong. But I guess
I said I've never. I don't ask for anything flat out. I would like things, I guess.
Yeah, anything, please.
Yeah, send us something if you want.
That would change everything. Yeah.
But anyway, what else do we got to talk about here today, huh? What do you know?
Well, there's a lot of stuff in the game. You and I did a little traveling across the galaxy. You know, we hopped galaxies, right?
We went and visited the Starsider people. Yeah, we went to the play there.
Yeah, it was a Life Day Carol put on by HGS.
Yeah, the Hollywood Galactic Studios.
That's it.
Lona and her crew. And that was fun to see how they do a play in the Star Wars Galaxies world. Thanks to those people for inviting us. We had a good time seeing how they do things over in Starsider and HGS Guild. And
it was a packed hall, I gotta say.
They did a lot of work, I think, to get ready for it and everything. So they were seemed pleased with their results as well. So thank you for that. And you can always follow what they have going on in the forums at HGS. The Starsider forums, probably. And I think they have their own public forum somewhere, too.
I think they have it on YouTube also, if I recall.
Oh, yeah, you can go see the play there.
The whole thing, yeah.
You go take a look at it and look at us in the audience. And, you know, there we are.
It was packed.
It was packed. And then some people thought we were like moving after that too, by the way.
So bored of that. Yeah, aren't you?
Yeah. Then we go and visit a server and we were out of it for a little while and everybody gets to losing their grandeur.
Gain 20 pounds. And
oh my gosh. Wait, are you calling me fat, Mr. Bubble?
No, I'm saying the Han Solo effect.
Oh, I see.
The carbonite effect.
That happens too, yeah. The carbonite effect.
Right.
Mm-hmm. I like that.
Yeah, well, what was that? What are we talking about? Yeah, it's just, you know, we're going to pick other servers and just visit. Big deal.
Yeah.
That's it. That's the way I see it.
Well, that you're just exploring. You went a few times just to see what Starfighter was like.
Right.
It's not like you're sitting there exploring for a new place to go.
Right.
I don't know. Anyway, we're not moving, so that's the key to that thing. I haven't been on much again. I don't know. You were on a little bit, though, for a while.
I had a spurt there for a couple weeks when I was getting ready for that, just to figure things out. But, yeah. You know, comes and goes. It's just December's a busy month in
the
real life for me.
Comes and goes.
Right. Kind of like stepping on a rusty nail.
Yeah. It's making me feel uneasy.
Yeah. No, I checked out Life Day launched yesterday. I just logged in.
Yeah, the 15th.
Yeah.
Life Day.
Same as last year pretty much, isn't it?
Yeah. There's some new decorations I believe you can get. If you missed the stap last year, you can get that again now.
Oh, good. I do need one in this new character.
Yeah. Yep.
Or in this new server, I need one.
Yep, you can get that again.
Okay,
and
good. That's worth it. That's worth it right there.
Yeah, it doesn't take much to do it
right.
To get the thing for the quest.
Yeah, I just deleted. I just lost it because of the free character transfer. Something
what did
there.
You do? I don't know what it was.
I don't know what it was. I did the re-engineer thing, and then yeah, it's in the jungle. It's out there.
It's in the jumble, but yeah, that's okay. Jungle works too.
No, I definitely need to get one of those in. That'd be fun because those are kind of. I miss that vehicle because when it's re-engineered, it can go faster.
They're still working on the Galactic Civil War update. We don't know. I don't know what that's not going to be before Christmas, obviously. They're going to increase the frame rate
for animations
to 60 frames per second.
All right.
Instead of 30. So if you were using a mod for that before, you won't have to. Some people were in there complaining, well, the mod lets you go to 100 and some. Come on, people. In this game, it doesn't really make a difference what your frame rate is like for combat-wise stuff.
Right.
The combat system is so behind the frame rate, it's not even funny. So why are you so worried about it? I don't understand that.
That's a nice change. I mean, that's good. Good. That's all good.
The dancing should be looking pretty good, I think.
Yeah,
the
just ribbons, character appearance, yeah.
Ribbons
just
and things.
Everything's more smooth.
Smooth.
Like an Obi-Wan enema.
I didn't say anything.
Obi-Wan does
I'm not going to talk about enemas.
No, but he does run an enema business on Coronet.
I don't think that's true.
Yeah, when he tests them, we have audio of him testing like a really strong enema. Okay, they're just putting it in. What does he say?
It's making me feel uneasy.
Oh, sorry, too much.
Obi-Wan enemas. Obi-enemas.
Obi-enemas.
Oh. O-W-E. Come to O-W-E. Oh, and you'll say, oh!
There'll be one. They're not uncomfortable.
He's right.
If you get the wrong enema, here's what it sounds like when he tries the wrong enema.
Another happy landing.
Enough of the enema.
Right. Obi-Wan's enemas.
Nice.
They're very healthy, though.
It's a high colonic. A high Kenobi.
Mm-hmm.
Come and try the high Kenobi.
Obi-Wan colonic, yeah.
Yeah. He's right.
That's what they call him at the Jedi Academy. Is old.
I have to report to the council.
Obi-Wan Kalanick.
You know. Obi-Wan Kalanick.
Yeah, the frame rate's a big deal. I mean, we should not underestimate that. That makes an old game look new. I mean, for some people, it just... You and I played with that little hack thing, whatever it was, to crank it up, and damn, that looked great.
It looked different. It looked better.
Absolutely. Smooth.
So we have no idea when that's going to happen, though. It's going to be with the Galactic Civil War update, whenever that does come out. Or at least that's what it sounded like,
in the
notes. So now that's all the way.
Now that we got some voicemail today. When do you want to do that? Should we do that?
I don't know. Do you feel like it?
I could use at least one or two, or maybe some. Yeah,
a sprinkling.
Mm-hmm.
A voicemail. Okay,
just like an Obi-Wan treat.
Well, let's see what we have. Let's see what we have here.
Hi, my name is Thomas, and I live in Oakland, California. I started playing Star Wars Galaxies in about 2004, but I canceled my subscription about 2 years ago, and I listened to your guys' podcast day one, and I still listen to it even now, even though I don't play. It's just a good podcast about Star Wars and tomfoolery and whatnot, and I really enjoy what you guys do, and keep it up. If you guys stopped making your podcast, there would be an empty hole in my life. And also would like to say that, yes, I have signed up for the Old Republic beta, and I'm just hoping that it's going to bring a brand new, fresh Star Wars gaming community. Okay, keep up the good work again. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you for listening, Thomas. Thank you very much. Old Republic, yes. We'll talk about that later. Or, you know, there's another game also. We'll talk about that. But
we could do Free Realms Cast.
Oh, God.
We certainly wouldn't be for the right target audience, I'm thinking. We might get in trouble with that. We wouldn't get in trouble, but, you know, we're...
Keep going.
No.
Go on.
What do you mean, Yivvits?
I have to report to the council.
Don't tell them.
Obi-Wan, come back. Come back, Obi-Wan. Over here.
No, thank you. That's really nice of you. It's always nice to hear when people say they enjoy our show and they like to hear us, so it makes us feel good. So thanks a lot.
Hey, Yivvits and Mr. Bubble. This is Susina of the Galactic Holofeed Podcast, and I was wondering if you've heard about the housing system in Second Life. All the housing is open world. All the buildings are player-made, including, you know, which wall goes where. All the furniture, clothing designs, it's all made by players. And it's that very sandbox social experience of parties and stuff that you guys seem to really love. There's no grinding, no camping for mobs for loot. There's no monthly fee until you decide to buy land to build a house on. At that point, the fee depends on, you know, if you buy something small or something bigger, like an island or something. Well, that's all I wanted to ask. I've been listening to you guys for a couple years now, probably, but this is my first time calling in. So, in closing, I'd like to say I'm Alan.
Well, thank you very much for calling. See, we do have female listeners, Mr. Bubble.
Right.
You keep saying we don't, but I know we've got one. The ones that said they were female before, they were pretending.
Well, who cares?
Or they had their female friends act right. Like they were them.
Right.
A Second Life housing. What do you say? What say you?
Well, okay, that's valid. When we say there's nothing, because I have said that before, there's nothing like SWG for housing. And of course, there are other things. Second Life has the type where... Just that you explain, everything can be customizable. You could have your own t-shirts and posters and that kind of stuff. It's a little different than like World of Warcraft and those where you have a huge, huge client content. Like in SWG, every object in the game is actually on your hard drive.
Yeah.
And the server just says display this object here, there. I think in Second Life, when I tried it a couple years ago, I mean, it has to transmit all the data for the object to you.
Which would make sense if it's fully customized.
Yeah, right. Because if you make a, hey, I'm Yivvits t-shirt...
Right.
You know, unless they patch the client to add that shirt to every, you know.
You have a nightmare. Huge client.
Right. And it's just a different experience. It's a different kind of game. I guess I can't say it's not like it's the ultimate sandbox game, I guess.
I would, if you can build out your own wireframes and all that stuff. There's also something called too much sandbox, where the ability to do all that stuff also could take away from, I don't know, your overall enjoyment by, I don't know. It depends what you're looking for, I guess.
Yeah.
If you're looking for, like, houses that, I don't know how to say it.
I guess in my mind, I always knew it was there, but it just didn't seem like the same type of MMO in the sense of where you have the grind and XP and structure and professions and this and that.
Right.
It's more of a hangout place. Because before SWG, I mean, if you've heard the old podcast, you've heard me talk about the one called There, T-H-E-R-E.
Yeah.
Very similar to Second Life. In fact, a lot of Second Life people are from there originally.
Where?
I know, I hate that name.
Where are they from?
They're from there. Yeah.
They're from there.
Right.
Okay.
I told you his name. Yeah, no, but it's like that was a... There was... Very similar to that.
What?
And it has housing, I was talking to a coworker about the Free Realms housing, because it's fully instance housing.
No, that just came online, right?
Yeah, that was yesterday. And I had to check that out to see, because there, not Free Realms, but there, that game there is not instance housing. You can walk up to somebody's house just the way you can in SWG and in Second Life. But SWG is still heavily client-based. The bottom line, it plays a lot snappier, and there's more action and more content, really. Things to do, spaceships to fly around.
It keeps a theme going as well, which is Star Wars. And if you were to go to Second Life, you may maybe have a great experience, except for if you wanted to be in that Star Wars world at the same time, that might be a problem.
I mean, it's a different kind of game. I mean, I was at the Minnesota State Fair, and in the educational exhibit, they did have some university of, not U of M, but just some Minnesota colleges are doing classes in Second Life. It showed students, their avatars or toons sitting around a picnic table by the teacher, that kind of thing. And that's what Second Life to me is, that kind of free form.
Now, this was a school, actual school, not like some kind of make-believe, role play kind of dirty thing.
No.
Oh, okay. I just want to be sure.
No. It was one of the colleges in Minnesota that was doing that. And there's just free round. Like Ira Flatow on Science Fridays, right?
I was going to say that, actually. I was just going to say that. How many people go into that with Ira?
I have no idea. Ira.
Ira.
But,
Plato.
That's valid. But
it's a valid point.
In my head, I'm thinking of the ones where you pay $15 a month. They're pretty common. It's like Lord of the Rings, World of Warcraft, Star Wars Galaxies, EverQuest. You know, that type of niche, that kind of model. Right. And
there aren't any like that.
Well, they're not as many. Yeah, right.
Not as many. There's not really any that have the housing
Good call. Thanks for listening.
Yes, and it's nice to know.
Hey, Yivvits and MrBubble. This is Neek from the Dolphin Galaxy. The Shadowfire Galaxy now, I guess. Anyways, I'm just calling in to say thanks for the great podcast. Really enjoying it, as always. So I just wanted to comment on where is this game going anyways? Because there seems to be a little bit of concern about how long the game will last and so on. So I think it's a very good point, and it needs to be addressed. There's been lots of additions to the game lately, such as the Chronicles and some heroics and so on. But where is the game really going? I think the player base really needs to have an answer to that so that we really know how long the game is going to last and so on. I think most of us really do enjoy the core content of the game, or we wouldn't even be playing it. But knowing how long it will last would really give us some confidence in the money we spend on it every month. Anyways, really enjoy your podcast. Thanks for everything.
It's Neek. Neek's a Bothan.
Neek.
Neek is a little Bothan in our guild.
A wee one.
It's nice to hear from you, Neek. And yes, we did get your voicemails. We got both of them, and we spliced them together just brilliantly, I hope, so you can't even tell, really. Where's the game going? I don't know where it's going. I think they play it just day by day, probably.
Yeah. I have a perfect answer for where it's going.
Okay, where's it going, Mr.
It's going Rumble? Where it's already been. I don't think there's anything really groundbreaking coming out. If people are waiting for something exciting to happen, I think it's already the best is behind us.
I agree.
For the mechanics of the game, the rest is all for us to make. And with Chronicles and all the other methods of content, I mean, socialize Chronicles, fight things, blow up stuff, whatever. I mean, it's for us to do. I don't think after this amount of time, especially with other stuff on the horizon, that they're ever going to, you know, just come out with something that's just jaw-dropping, groundbreaking. No.
So your answer to that question from Neek is nothing.
Right. I don't think they're holding back anything that's just off the charts. Yeah.
Not holding back potted plants or anything like that. Or
potted plants would be off the charts. If they can't do potted plants, what are the odds of anything else?
That's a good point.
Yeah.
Well, see, they have to put it in the schedule, and it takes like 10 months for them to
get
there.
Right. But, and you have to get the art approved.
Which is true.
Of course it's true.
The artwork, the artwork's been in there for years.
Oh, that's true.
But they did find enough time to push out another TCG expansion.
Yeah.
That just came live on the 15th.
Yeah, that's true.
And there should be some clarification there, I think. And I can't say this 100%, but I'm pretty sure this is how it is. Yes, the art team, the Star Wars Galaxies art team, which is really probably just the DC Online art team on weekends or something, they don't do the graphics on the cards. The card studio does those. But who do you think has to do the in-game items?
Oh, right.
The in-game items are still done by the teams.
Yeah, I would assume that's in Austin.
There are people
that
argue that, though. They don't understand that's not how it works.
Oh.
They're like, well, we know that the thing, you know, the other team does the artwork. Yeah, well, the artwork for the cards. They don't know the tools of the game or anything
like
that.
But the game mechanica is in
the mechanica,
Austin.
Yeah. So they found time to put all these buildings in, all this stuff. And that made me realize, finally, in the past, I think we said that the TCG was actually supporting the game and keeping it alive, you know, with money. I don't think that's true. I think the TCG keeps the TCG alive. I don't think there's any money that they make from that thing that they're putting into Star Wars Galaxies.
Probably not.
Because if that was the case, I think that we should be seeing some of that stuff come from the regular game system. I mean, that's...
Yeah.
How many years do we wait for buildings and we get a couple and then they add, oh, sure, it's not a big deal to put these in through the TCG. You know, buy these cards and then you might get them. You might get them. There's a small chance you might get them. You tell me how fair that is. I hope that they can do some cool things with the Galactic Civil War update. And I just saw that they actually put it on Test Center now. So that's kind of cool. I'll get in there and look at it and see what it's all about.
Cool.
The fact that I've always said, even after the NGE, you know, if you don't fix the systems that were broken at the core, everything you do on top of it is tarnished.
Mm-hmm.
And to me, that's how I feel about a lot of the stuff that they put in. It's not that they don't do a good job. It's that everything they put in still is built on top of that sandy foundation.
It's like my 76 Plymouth. I mean, it was a crappy car. I mean, no matter what I put on the outside of it, it's just a crappy car.
Could look great, but it was...
It's still stalled. I couldn't get that thing to not stall.
So it's unfortunate that that was never taken into account. That's why I can't get excited about a lot of stuff in there. And I want to. I would love to, but I can't. If I don't like the combat system or it looks bad or stuff doesn't work, it affects everything. So in any case, I hope that I don't know. I don't know where the future is for it. I don't. I hope it sticks around in some degree, and maybe we won't all play it all the time, but I hope it doesn't have to go away just because there are some cool things that are fun in there to do.
Oh, I think it could be there a long time in the same state it's in. I mean, if it's lasted this long since the NGE, I mean, it's hard to argue that it could be around 5 more, 10 more years if they wanted.
Maybe down to one server or something. Well, seriously, they could.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know, there's EverQuest for Mac. Is that still alive?
Ultima Online is still out there.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I don't think that has to go away. I just think more and more of the people get siphoned off by these more compelling games. So
I see.
Certain segments will go to Sweater, certain segments will go to Trek Online, certain segments will go to Stargate Online. I mean, they're endless. These things are endless. So
Endless. They never end.
No.
So what are they? They're endless?
They're endless.
It's like a circle. Like
endless love.
It's like a ring.
My
go around the ring.
Endless love.
Thank you for that.
It's making me feel uneasy.
Yeah,
me
too. Sorry, Obi-Wan.
Me too. Me too. We also have said that if LucasArts would actually spend the money towards an expansion, a real expansion, and really get in there and do stuff, that could bring people back and keep it alive. And that's not going to happen, just from all signs. All signs point to no on that one. No.
Mr. 8-Ball.
Yes.
No.
Keep playing, no. Man. It's no. the people, if your friends are in there, keep playing. No reason not to say hi to your friends and hang out with your friends.
Well, and that's the other thing, too, is that if you're still having fun, then that's great if you're having fun. I think you should keep playing it a lot, then. Thanks again, Neek, for calling. We will see you in the guild. Speaking of guild.
Yeah. Oh, guild,
You know our guild on the server?
Yeah, that's one of my favorite guild.
Yivvits and MrBubble Podcast Aficionados Guild.
Yes.
The purpose of our guild is what? It's essentially kind of a fan club, but it's not just a fan club in that sense. We're just there to be a place for people to go if they don't necessarily play a lot or they play a little. You know, we've never committed to always being on there or at least being on there for X number of hours. We've never committed that. And we've also never had a problem if people want to leave and move on to something else. We've always, you know, kind of advertise ourselves as a stepping stone. If you're trying to figure out where to go and you just want to have a guild tag while you're experimenting, you know, like Mr. Bubble during the 80s, his guild tag was something different.
That's a funny line. That's good.
But thank you.
Little Mr. Bubble in the late 80s.
I'll be here all week.
Yeah.
That's what we can be there for. And will there be lots of people online? Probably not. Our guild is a big guild of alts from other servers. And that's fine, and we love it. And we love seeing the people that are in there when they're on there, and we love to talk to them. Will we miss you when you go? Yeah, we'll miss you, but we'll know that you're having fun doing your other thing now.
Right.
And that's important. It's not about us in that aspect. Mr. Rubble, by the way, it's
a tag. It's what?
He's just discovered how delicious pistachio nuts are today.
Hell yeah.
So he's been eating pistachio nuts.
I am 41,
like crazy.
And I've never nommed on these in this
match. You haven't?
I've had some.
You know they have pistachio ice cream?
No, they don't.
Yes, they do.
What's ice cream?
Oh, I agree.
I don't know what ice cream is. It's like creamed ice.
I'm not aware of this.
Or is it iced cream?
I hear there's a place called...
What is this you speak of? I hear there's a place making something up north.
They have something called iced cream.
I got something called ice gratin up there.
Now, Oh, what the heck were we talking? Yeah, guild thing. It's like a badge of honor, having YAM on your guild tech. That's awesome.
Or a badge of shame. I'm not sure.
Either one. But hopefully with us, you get enough people that are like-minded and have some laughs in the guild chat. We're not going to be there a lot of times. It's just...
Yeah. You know, we all play at weird times. Mr. Bubble, our cycles are usually off from each other. His and my cycles are usually off.
He's Neptune and I'm Pluto, and sometimes we're orbiting right by each other. In
2012, we're going to line up, but...
And then the oceans get torn apart and everything.
Yeah, and Las Vegas goes away.
Oh.
And everything else. Oh. So sorry if you're living like L.A. and those places. But we still love you. No, but that's all. Just remember that you know, we're there for you if you need a place to go and call home. But we're not always on, and that's how it is. And we won't feel bad if you want to leave. And if you want to come back, we'll be just as happy to see you again, too.
Prodigal son, read that story.
Yeah, so you love that story, don't you?
I do.
It's just almost as much as those pistachio nuts.
Oh, even slightly better, but yeah.
Okay.
The pistachio nuts are slightly less confusing than the prodigal son.
I don't know. You're having a tough time opening that one up.
Hey. just as I have a tough time understanding prodigal son.
Obi-Wan, he was trying to have some too. Do you see him? He was trying to get the nut out. He couldn't get it open. He was just... I don't know if he's weak. I told him to use the force. He wouldn't do it, so...
It's never happened before.
Well, yeah. It's probably the first time he's ever had those before.
Possibly.
Well, on to the next voicemail.
Yes.
Hello, boys. This is Granny Pledge here. I'm on Kashyyyk with Tarth for the holidays. You may know him from the forest. Oh, no. I'm so sorry. That was Tarth. I'm just saying, boys, to see how you are and to tell you that I'm very proud of you. You've been working very hard. I can tell that, and I'm very proud that you're continuing with the game and having fun on the other servers. I just wanted to say also that you are the real. I've met you before, obviously, and you know my daughter Pledge. You may know her from before. She speaks very kindly of you. Yivvits, very kindly indeed. And I'd also like to say that I've never heard you boys ask for pocket money, as you mentioned in episode 122. I think that's all I've got to say. I've been very well treated, both by yourself and by Darth. And I hope you guys have a lovely holiday, and I'll catch up with you soon. And please keep up the good work. Okay? It's goodbye from me, and... Oh, my word, it's head tickles. I'll speak to you soon, boys. Bye-bye.
Grandma Pledge.
Oh,
I didn't know that Pledge had a grandma.
No.
That's interesting. I did not know that. And Tarf. Tarf is a Wookiee.
Yeah.
He says hi to us in the official forums. He's in the background. He's got a... I think that's Tarf. That was either Tarful or Tarf. I'm not sure. I think it was Tarf. I couldn't tell now that you... Now that I think about it. Well, anyway, if it was Tarf, Tarf has got a Bordock named Buttercup.
Oh, that's the cutest name ever.
Buttercup and Farnsworth.
Buttercup.
They get together. They run around on the weekends. Next voicemail here is queued up and ready to be fired out the chute.
All right.
Hi guys, this is Tarp here from Chim Chimmy Chimera, or you may know me better as Burrito Bob. Just wanted to phone up and say happy Christmas to you guys. I hope you guys have a lovely Christmas with your families and you're all safe. And keep up the good work and look forward to listening to more next year. I hope you guys keep playing and have a good Christmas. Cheers, bye.
Okay, now that was Tarf, I think he said. Tarf, because Tarf is from Chimera.
Chimera.
And Burrito Bob from our server Shadowfire. He has a tune there. So, Burrito Bob. Yeah, well, thank you. Happy Married Life Day to you as well, Burrito Bob Tarf. I think that's what he said. I couldn't quite understand him, but I'm pretty sure that was. So one of our callers was Tarf today.
Yeah.
One of the two of them.
Yep.
I'm not really sure which one. Thank you for that rousing round of music, by the way, too. That was
I like all the Wookiees.
That was something.
Yeah, how does Larry say it? Okay.
Okay. Yeah. I don't know if that plays over the podcast very well.
No.
But yeah, Larry David, yeah. Yeah, okay.
Hi, Yivvits MrBubble. It's Darth Venkman, otherwise known as Drekken. Did you feel boring to get Kells and Spatial Spam? You can find Gold Farmers on at all playtimes. Huge stock on all server. But what are we going to do about it? I think us and Seth were talking at one stage about, you know, more effective ways to flag these guys and have them processed. I'd like to see something in that, but I think another way that we might be able to do it is to undercut them. Like you guys were talking about in episode 121, the EQ2 welcome screen, bringing that into SWG, something like it. I think you could also bring over the EQ2 marketplace that they've got happening, and in that sell loot items from the TCG that are outgoing every time there's a new expansion, you know, the ones that would be harder to get from the first couple of sets. That might reduce some of the complaints about the TCG and the loot system as well, if people eventually had a means to get that. But more importantly, we could actually sell credits there if necessary and undercut these guys and get them out of the game. Love your work, guys. See you later.
Hey, thanks for calling, Darth Venkman.
Venkman. I just watched Ghostbusters.
Did you?
I did.
Hmm. Were they eating pistachio nuts on Ghostbusters? Were they?
No.
Answer me that.
No. They were eating them in one of the Naked Gun movies, though, I think.
Really?
Yeah. When they were staking out the victim and they had, like, they just keep dumping the shells outside the cars and there was, like, a mountain of a hill at one point.
I have to report to the council.
Okay.
About the pistachio nuts.
I think so.
A marketplace to undercut the people who are selling credits. Maybe, but I could see that actual system could be abused by the people that you're actually trying to get rid of.
Oh, that's true. That's true. They could use that as their mechanism to,
yeah, to get right, money, right. And yeah. Then it legalizes it for them, and maybe that would work. I don't know. It's hard to say. The other thing is that of all the games that they're worried about it in, I'm not sure Star Wars Galaxy is the most important one. But maybe I know that they do take it very seriously at the same time. So I don't want to make it sound like they don't care, because they do, because it's a huge chunk of money for them. And if it affects their bottom line, then they're going to do something about it. And if they haven't done anything besides the Warden system, then either they're happy with that, or the difference between the amount of time that would take to, you know, put something else in is greater than the amount of money they lose from it.
Right, 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 right.
And that's what I have to assume. So
yeah,
that's that. But anyway, I guess.
Yeah, I wouldn't look for any changes in that either.
I don't know what to say about that.
Yeah.
But those are all the voicemails we got. Thanks again for calling.
Yay,
everybody.
Voicemail. Do we have our plate cleared of voicemails?
No, we don't. But I'm not going to play anymore.
Okay.
No, because if we do too many of them, we get sick of them.
Oh, okay.
No, we don't get sick of voicemail. And we do store them all and keep them. But
yes,
there's a couple other things to talk about.
We etch them on a disc and put them on a space probe and put them into space.
Yes.
Eject them.
We fax them.
Yes. Yes. We fax them.
We transpose them and then fax them to Obi-Wan, and then he, of course,
I have to report to the council.
He has to report to the council with them, and he lets them know all about the voicemails. So all of your innermost details have been told to the council.
He's just talking about the Yambora City Council, right?
Oh, yeah. So, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Right.
He's on it.
Yeah. Figured.
Yeah. I know. He always had to be.
Yep.
He complained about it, and he was like,
wait a minute.
Yes, you did. You were all whiny little boy about it and just stupid.
I didn't say anything.
You were there, Mr. Bubble.
He was pretty whiny, and then he kind of felt uncomfortable. How do you feel?
It's making me feel uneasy.
That's right. That's you.
That was a nice setup.
That's right.
Oh, all right. So anyway, what else is going on in the world of just you?
Oh, I don't know. I forgot about Star Trek Online. Not that I knew it was coming out, but I forgot how close it was. Because remember, that was developed from like 2004 to 2008. Four solid years. Because a lot of people were watching that. Just because. It's Star Trek. and then it went away for, you know, someone else bought it, I think, right?
Yeah, so they got then, sold off to their team.
Then Leonard Nimoy came out last year and said...
And he's going to develop it?
Yeah, he's a developer.
Yeah.
No, but he said, hey, it's coming out like in a year or whatever. And, but anyway, it's coming out. I mean, by February, it's going to be out, according to their timelines.
In beta.
No, beta's 2 weeks. That's the end of January. There's a two-week beta cycle in January. That's it?
That's it. Wow.
It's closer. I think it's closer than we think. 2 week beta cycle, and then it launches in February. And it's a lot of people I respect are dropping for it. I'm not going to drop everything, but I mean, my God, this is Star Trek. This is not Conan. I'm dropping my Conan. I'm canceling Conan and, yeah, Trek Online. So I apologize in advance if I talk a lot about Trek Online during the podcast.
There's
but,
no need to apologize for that.
I'm just telling people I'm keeping my swing count active, but I feel the calling of getting a starship and exploring the universe. I mean, I want that.
I thought you were going to talk about something else you're feeling the calling.
No, no. That exploring was done in the late 80s, that was as you said. Yeah. But, no, I mean, that's their bit.
It's making
is,
me feel uneasy.
Yeah, Obi-Wan, whatever. But, but that's the bit is you get a starship and you're the captain and the rest of the thing is NPCs, I guess, in your starship.
So there's
and,
no other players in your starship?
I don't think so. I don't know. I don't know that. I mean, it, and you as captain, you get to shuffle around like your energy and phasers and all that kind of stuff. And, you know, just picture those kind of battles, that strategy. And we all like the space and then computer-generated planets and this kind of, I mean, it sounds interesting. And it's based in the Star Trek universe, which is well-established. So I'm definitely going to hang out there a while and ride it because betas are fun. You get new stuff. Like the one of the beta things I think you get is like the new Captain Kirk type or the Captain Kirk type starship.
Oh, okay.
And I need that.
Who you does? Do.
Of course I need that.
Yeah.
Yeah. So there. I mean, Star Trek Online, sign up for it. I want to see some of my friends over there and we'll keep our swig accounts going. I mean, don't freak out.
We've never made a commitment to anything as far as just like our guild.
No, but whenever you know how it is, whenever we say something on here,
yeah, well, of course, yeah. But we've also had people that say that have told us too that they don't really care what we talk about. We could talk about what we do talk about weird things too, like going to the Aveda salon. So obviously they find that entertaining. So they would just
well, we still seem to have a focus on swig though, no matter what.
Well, that's true.
So that's what I'm saying.
You never know. But so you're just excited about that.
Oh
then.
My God, yeah. Star Trek. It's not Conan. I mean Conan I a tenth of a percent of Conan was my interest as to what Star Trek is. I mean, my earliest memories are of Star Trek. That predates Star Wars. I mean,
yeah, that does. Yeah.
And Star Wars was like a roller coaster ride, but Star Trek has been part of me from then to now, and I endlessly discuss the plots with friends like you and just anybody that's into Star Trek. And you and I have gone to many Star Trek conventions. We haven't gone to many
the
Star
old
Wars.
Days.
Right. It's all Trek. And think of the spin-offs.
Did they really have Star Trek? Did they have Star Wars conventions?
I don't know. I mean, someone will probably correct us, but I don't know. But Star Wars is always like more pew, 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 you know, like that kind of stuff.
Lightsabers.
Star Trek, I mean, Star Trek talks about concepts and ideas. And just almost in any of the series, even the series that people despise the most, they still have some interesting plots, you know, but there's just so much to pick from. So God, I hope they just give it a tenth of what it needs. But if they can just get it where you are in a starship exploring and somehow have a starbase where you can interact with other people, that's going to hold a lot of people for a long time. And the people that have told me they're switching right away, I mean, you know what I'm, well, from the forums, Two-Tone, he said he's switching.
Two-Tones,
he's not just trying it out, he's switching.
Yeah.
He's saying his subject, his forum post was like, yes, you can have my stuff. He's moving on.
Yeah.
Another one that is doing that probably is Hubcap. He's sent me text messages and some other people like that. I mean, they're just, they're moving. It's all new terrain for them, and it's a new canon of material that they understand and people have lived and thought, and gee, wouldn't it be fun to be in that MMO? So, yeah, I hope they hit their timeline. I hope it's a decently fun game, so you never know. Yeah,
you don't ever know.
Yeah,
and that's where my hesitation is in that, because I you know, we talked a little bit earlier off the air that I wasn't exactly excited about it, kind of.
Mm-hmm.
And my issue with that is I've been burned too many times on these games when they get built up with all this emotion and expectations and stuff, and I just have learned to I don't expect anything until I see it, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
They gotta impress me.
Mm-hmm.
That's their what they gotta do. So, I mean, everything we talk about is speculation at this point anyway.
What do you mean by impress? What would impress thing
you
be?
Impress as far as, like, make it just, like, fun and make it fill the gap, I guess. It's different for everybody.
Right. That's what I'm asking. For you, what is it then?
I don't know what it is.
Okay.
It's ethereal.
For me, it's like a playground. I mean, I like to play around in areas, and if I can play around in the Trek universe, that is score. And if they don't put too many barriers up...
Barriers are bad.
Yeah, I mean, if they, you know, to me, a barrier is like, feels like a massive user interface problem, or if it's a massive hardware.
Or you just want to make quests, but you got to find all the relics for it.
Yeah, and the thing with Star Wars was, when I first started playing that, is everything was new in it. It was a brand new universe, and it was Star Wars based. And so if this, I hope this is like nothing out there. Maybe it's the same old crap. Maybe it's like World of Warcraft and... You have a combat level above your head, and yeah, a spreadsheet, and like maybe it is. I don't know. I mean, how unique could it be? I guess. I mean, if you think about it that way, what is?
If it captures the essence of the subject matter, that's always good too. But they also the track record, for games based on, you know, intellectual properties is not very good.
Hmm.
So to me, they've got a lot to work against in that. As far as even if it's not even warranted, if you know, if they have a great product, they're gonna have a tough time, you know, maybe getting into it.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't know. I mean, I know there's enough Star Trek fans in the universe that'll you know, make it big. I hope. I mean, you know.
Yeah, I think it's an untapped field because I think a lot of them are older and more mature, and certainly didn't fit with like the World of Warcraft stuff.
Right, or they did secretly.
Mm, yeah, it could be.
They're
could
closet be. Warcraft players.
Nah, it should be. It'll be fine. It totally caught me off guard, and as soon as I read some of the stuff lately, I realized, oh yeah, that's right. That's always been out there because we've talked about it. I mean,
yeah.
We've always talked about Trek Online coming out and Stargate's coming out too. I think still, I don't know.
I don't know what the status is on that one.
The thing I like about this Trek Online, to me, it totally frees me up when people ask me about the Old Republic.
Oh.
I can say, yeah, maybe I'll try that. Maybe I won't. And with Trek, I mean, I will try that. I will try that hard. A sweater, it would be a forced thing. I'd have to. It'd be like, well, you know, whatever. It's Star Wars. It's new. But this is like Trek? Oh, okay. Let's try it out. The thing is, Star Wars kept us here because we like Star Wars. And this is the only Star Wars MMO out there. I have the same feelings, if not stronger, for Star Trek.
Confusion is in you.
I mean, if this was a Battlestar Galactica game, I don't know if we'd be here.
It'd be awesome. It'd be awesome. You just want to be Starbuck, don't you?
Starbuck. Which one?
Oh, it has to be new. It can't be the old.
Why not? By your command.
It can't be that. No.
Oh, okay.
No. They can be in it.
Droid.
They can be in it.
Oh, okay.
But they can't. There's got to be this time frame that we knew.
Okay.
Yeah. I still think it could be great MMO. I don't know.
Galactica?
Yes.
Oh, heck yeah. Anything could be. That'd be a great one.
It could
sure.
be a really space heavy one.
Sure. By your command. I wish I had that robotic voice. Say that. Do that for me. By your command.
By your command. But anyway, we're going to talk about other games and other things. That's just the way it is. This stuff happens, and you got to just go with the flow.
But anybody listening, if you're into Star Trek, don't miss out on the beta, because you can get some stuff. And, you know, betas only come once in a game. You know what I mean? Yeah, and there's just, like in this one, there was always a point of pride of saying, yeah, I played Swig in beta, you know, that kind of thing.
Right.
Beta player, so don't
beta get... one, beta two. But see, if they're only in a two-week beta, that's weird to me.
Yeah.
Did they have a private beta for a long time?
Oh, yeah, it's closed. It definitely had a closed beta.
Oh, okay,
yeah.
That makes a difference. Because I guess the...
Open beta's 2 weeks.
The Star Wars Galaxies one was closed, too, originally.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, to me, this is like a sign of really being close, if you're having a 2 week open beta.
It was only 2 weeks between the announcement of the NGE and the NGE. Does that mean anything? I don't know.
I don't know.
I don't know either. So that's what you're thinking about then right now.
That hit me like, wow, yeah, that's kind of, hold on, grab onto that.
Okay.
Hold on to, I'm canceling Conan, man.
We'll talk more about that as the time gets closer. Maybe we'll have to add in some Jean-Luc Picard sound effects.
Engage. That'd be so awesome.
That's too easy.
We'd have to
find the better ones.
Right, right.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's, the deep, the Yivvits MrBubble type ones.
The Yivvits MrBubble ones.
Like,
definitely.
Because there are just...
Well, there's a huge source to go by.
9 years of him uttering mundane things.
We could have lots of things. We could have Deanna say lots of things.
Uh-huh.
Lots of things,
but
Mr.
Like
Bubble.
Picard, we could have Picard like say, oh, I like bananas or something like, I mean, there's got to be stuff like that. There's got to be really mundane sound bites.
My brother.
Yeah.
my brother with a vineyard.
Yeah. It's just endless. And that's just the next generation. I mean, you get Kirk and all his boys in on it.
Yeah, I'd make you do those sound effects because I'm just not turned on by that. But, well, I don't know. Is there anything else on the list, Mr. Rubble?
Uh-uh.
Other than that? We kind of do an unstructured show today. It was kind of just out there and weird. And
just had to be done. It's holiday times. So
we're both
get
busy with holidays, and we just thought we'd get something out, though. So I'm going to look in the mirror now. I'm going to do a self-affirmation like Stuart Smalley.
Yep.
Hello, me. I realize this wasn't my best show ever. I just hope you give me the power and the strength to go on because I'm good enough and I'm smart enough and doggone it, people like me.
Pistachios.
Pistachio. It'd be a good cat name.
Oh, that'd be cute as a little kitty.
Hello, Pistachio.
Oh.
What would his nickname be? Pit?
Tashi.
Pit?
Tashi. Or
Tashi.
Tasha. Tasha. Yar.
Pistachio. I could just say, come on, Pistachio. If you want to get more of our show, go to swgpodcast.com or go to our forums at yivvitsandmrbubble.com. Send us an email, comments at yivvitsandmrbubble.com. You can also send us a voicemail, which we'll love to play at some point. 888-900-YAMB. That's 9262. Or they can what?
They can follow the Twitter. It's YAMB. Just follow us. It's one. Or if you want to write us a letter, send it to Yivvits and Mr. Bubble. 168 Tyler Road, Studio 137, Red Wing, Minnesota 55066.
You can do that. We'd love to hear from you.
Try my product.
And if you do try our product, we'll continue to send you more shipments of our product at regular intervals.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Oh, and by the way, just an official goodbye to Two-Tone.
Oh, yeah.
We love Two-Tone.
Yeah.
And we hope we still see him around. In
Captain Two-Cone, flying around the universe.
Yes. And he can't be a Wookiee there. I don't know what he'll be.
Oh, I don't know.
Two-Tone's meant a lot to our show, and we just hope that he has fun in his new game, and he finds the things he's looking for in an MMO as well. So anyway, I guess that's all. You got anything else you want to say, Mr.
No,
Rubble?
No, thank you. Yivvits.
Anything important?
No.
Not so important?
No.
Thank you, Mr. Rubble.
Thank you, Yivvits.
Have fun, everybody.